Hello and welcome to our second round for this little project. Working on graduated washes. Just getting different ideas of how to do that, how color moves with water, how watery things have to be, and etc. etc. So for this next one, I'm gonna do a couple things. What I want to do for in the top row is continue with this graded wash that's representing the avocado, basically. Going from a light yellow to a little bit darker yellow green. So we're gonna our yellow is still gonna be our straight. The azo yellow that we're using, and I'm also going to mix up a little bit of yellow green by mixing a little bit of the yellow and a little bit of the peacock blue. So you'll be sort of practicing and learning about mixing colors. That was a lot, wasn't it? As well as intensity and concentration of the pigments. How much water? There's a lot of things to juggle here. So we'll practice and get better at it. So let's see. What I'm going to do is basically do a light wash of yellow over the whole shape, and then I'm going to bring in a little bit of this green and drop it into the yellow in the lower corner, and depending on how strong it is, how green it is, I may try to add some water, add some more yellow, or just let it mix around on the paper as well, which is a really fun thing. So, some watery yellow first. This is your basic flat wash sort of thing that we've been doing. Introducing some little bit more color up at the top, so it stays wet a little bit. I'm going to soak that up, the excess there, and then I'm going to see, I'm going to mix a little bit of this green. You know, that does look a little bit too greenish to me for this first round, so I'm going to mix it in with a little bit of the yellow to make sort of a yellow green. Definitely on the more on the green side of yellow green, but that's okay. Soak up that last part. Try that again. You can see over here, I do try to, when I'm grabbing color to mix, and I know that there's still a little bit of that color in the brush, and that it's gonna come out in the well. I hope you can see that right there. I usually just try to pick one side of the well, one side of the color to try to keep that the ability to still get clean color, pure yellow when I want that. For example, that I certainly see there's green down there, and I could worry about cleaning it out, or I could just sort of grab a little bit from the top. There is what I usually end up doing, and grabbing that to mix up some fresh, just pure yellow when I want that. try that again. I felt like the last one was getting a little bit unruly as far as what was drying, where the shape was drying and where it wasn't. And part of that just has to do with, you know, how quickly you put something in, how much water you put in, how much water is on the shape, how much you let one area dry or not dry. And I usually do move it around a little bit. It just seems like it will help sort of blend the two, and the two paints and the amount of water in the shape. And and it's also very important to let it dry in this direction, so it's still going from, you know, the water's still running down. So it is drying up here, but it's gradual enough in its transition that it's not going to create a bloom. For the second one, so wipe that flat and wipe a little bit of color out here. For the second one, I'm going to use the yellow and some quinacridone burnt orange. Same idea. Mixing up a little bit of yellow. Mixing up a little bit of the quinacridone burnt orange. Rinsing out my brush. Always rinsing out my brush. Pretty much being in that habit is, I think, the best thing, even though there's going to be times when you're wasting a little bit of paint. To me, it's certainly worth it just to not be surprised what paint is coming out on your paper. So, let's see. Let's go for a same idea. I'm going to do sort of a flat wash of yellow. It's light yellow. Light, sort of watery. Yellow by definition is light in a way. Here's my flat wash. I'm going to bring in a little bit more. And then I'm going to go over here and grab a little bit of that quinacridone burnt orange and start mixing in with the yellow, and then start dropping it in here to the lower right corner. There's a lot of water in there. I just got some of the water and stuff out of there, and then I'm mixing in. Yeah, that's a little bit more concentrated of that. We'll keep practicing that. In fact, we'll keep practicing it right now. Let's see. This is representing basically the pit of the avocado, the two colors we're going to be using to get mixtures of that. But starting with this yellow. very similar to another paint called Quinacridone Gold, but see, I'm going to bring in a little bit stronger stuff. I can see the pooling paint in the other shape. I encourage you to do this a little bit more one at a time. I'm trying to do them quickly for efficiency and videotaping. But it's easy to sort of, when you start working on two areas, it is easy to sort of lose sight of one, and there's too much pooling color, it can cause a bloom, or it can just sort of shift around in ways that you don't want it to when you're dealing with another color. So that's the second pass for that middle row. Let's see, this third row is going to be a little bit different. This is one where I've tried to sort of play a little bit more, try to loosen up a little bit more and not be so perfectionist. But I am gonna, let's see, I'm gonna start with a little bit of light blue. There's lots of yellow still around here. Let me, ooh, I sure hope that's in frame. There's lots of light, wait a minute, start that again. Start out with light blue. And for this shape, I'm gonna go from this, it's still peacock blue. I'm going to do sort of a light blue, and then after that, I'm gonna bring in a little bit of the quinacridone rose and mix that with the blue and sort of go from a bluish to a blue violet kind of thing. Let's see what happens. Flat wash of blue. Let's look at that last part. And then mix up a little bit of these two colors that I have. Once again, don't want it too dry. Don't want that mix too watery. It can be tricky to find that balance. But I usually sort of move things around like this and sort of try to even out the, I will say more important is evening out the water more so than the color for me. I'm gonna try to just bring in a little bit, it's too watery, but a little bit of darker violet mix. As I'm doing this, I'm realizing, yeah, I was gonna try to lighten up a little bit on that shape. I didn't really do that, did I? that may say a decent amount about me. But let's try to get a little bit more playful with this last one. Let's see, some light blue. And let's see what happens if I just start sort of introducing a little bit of different color, like on the way down. And let's see what happens if I just start introducing some straight quinacridone rose into there. That's fine. pretty rosy. Maybe I'll bring in a little bit more blue. And this is still trying to keep the idea of going from a lighter area to a darker area. That color's not really moving as much as I was wanting it to, so as hopefully I've said several times, the paint's not moving, it's because there's not enough water. So I'm going to bring in a little bit of water and heck, a little bit of the light blue too. Woo! Gonna move now. I'm curious how that's gonna dry. And I hope you guys can get really to that point after you sort of keep doing this and thinking about it and getting more comfortable with this. You're gonna get more comfortable with this. Because you're gonna sort of start learning like, oh, okay, well, I'm kinda curious how that's gonna dry. I know if it dries really, really off. I'm still keeping it basically light. I know where I want it light and where I want it dark. I can adjust things as I keep layering. Let me stop for now.